Hello everybody, today we're looking at Ansible. This video is called Ansible Day 1. What I'm using is Cisco 3750 switches, real hardware, not EVE-NG or IOU or GNS3 or anything like that. If you want to do that, then that's also good. There's no difference, or there should, well, there may be differences, but the concept is the same. What I'm just going to talk about first is issues with SSH if you've got old hardware. And then we'll talk about some Ansible terms, hosts, inventory, playbook. And really, this is just dipping the toe in the water. And there's plenty of better videos than this out there, but you may not find ones where there is somebody struggling to get off the ground and just take their first steps with Ansible. So this is really just a guide to getting Ansible up and running. And Ansible is written in Python. It's released by Red Hat, and it's useful for automating networks, network automation. You may have read about Paramico or NetMiko, and actually you do need to install that to get Ansible running, as you will see. I've already done that. You will see in due course that I've already done that. First thing I want to talk about is the hosts file. So anyone who's used to administering networks, you'll typically have a file that stores the IP addresses and the names of all the devices on the network. And that here is /etc/etc/ansible. And I've got one switch, it's called a router here. I've pasted in some text and I've not edited the name in brackets. So the name in brackets is what corresponds with another file, which I'll show you next. So these lines, this is basically the name and Ansible hosts, and then the IP address of my switch. So we've got some variables. So the network use, this is iOS and this is Cisco iOS. Don't confuse it with Apple or anything like that. Admin, Cisco, username, password, and network CLI. So just do that for now. Don't worry about the, I was viewing that read only. Right. Get out of that. Come on, quit. Quit. That's better. Okay, so one of the things you need to do is install Paramico if you see any issues with logging in. Then you write what's called a playbook. So, what's going on here? Oh, I'm still in the etc directory. So let me just show you that other file there. We've got ansible.cfg. And we'll need to update that in future, but for now, this works for today. So I'm trying to show you the bare minimum to get up and running. So we've got the hosts file, which we've just looked at. And then we've got what's called the playbook. So first playbook. And you see where the cursor's flashing? That's routers. That has to match what you just saw inside the square brackets. Name is just text. Gather facts is force. We don't want to do a show run and gather all that to start with. We're actually going to do that anyway. So the name of this command is show version on the routers. IOS command, again, that's Cisco IOS. Don't confuse that with Apple. The command we're going to do here is show run. You can put other parameters after that, so you can do a pipe, and then you can do a secondary command. Register the output, and then we're going to print the output. So register is basically setting a variable. So then we do print, and then print that variable. So without further ado, let's run it. And the syntax to run Ansible is, let me just go back up. Ansible playbook space first playbook dot yml. The dot yml is YAML file, so if you've not come across YAML before, it's a format for, it's not code, it's a markup language or markdown language even. Markdown, markup, I can't remember. Markdown. Right, let's run this. And as you can see there, it references Paramico. So once you've installed Ansible, you'll try and run it and you may get you'll get some error messages in red, and then you just need to do sudo apt-get install Paramico. So what it's doing is it's running some commands, and it's actually running the Cisco show run command. So it's showing the running configuration of my switch. So there you can see I've configured SSH. That's the IP address. That's my default gateway. Those are all the ports on my switch. That's my SSH key, which is no use to anybody on the internet. Those are my two usernames. And you can see it's running 12.2, which is quite old. And that's my host name, lower3750. So far, so good. What we've done is we've used Ansible, which is written in Python, and it enables us to, right, the key thing here is that I've done this on one switch. I've only got one switch. If I had five, what I would do would be to edit the file we were just looking at, which was in the hosts. So let's go back to hosts. Sudo vim hosts. Yeah, so here you see this line here. If I had a second router, I would replace that with 2. And say, for instance, it was IP address 99. Then I would go and get the running configs from both switches. Back to the previous directory. So yeah, this will run and it should work on the first switch but fail on the second switch. There we go, router 2 failed because router 2 is not actually, doesn't exist. So yeah, really the purpose of this video is to really just give you a quick introduction to showing you how Ansible works, MVP, minimum viable product. There we go, red and green. Router 1 works, router 2 doesn't because it doesn't exist. So what we've done is we've installed Ansible, which was just sudo. Did I do pip? I think it was, wasn't it? Pip install Ansible. There you go. Then I did pip install Paramico. Already installed. And then I edited the hosts file, which already existed, so I just came in and put these lines. So if you want to copy this, feel free. If your username's admin and your password is a Cisco and you've got a device with that IP address, it will work straight away. And then I wrote my playbook. So just edit the hosts, and then you can copy this playbook. I've copied it from the internet, so there we go. You'll get some warnings. That's Blowfish has been deprecated. So yeah, don't do this on a live network in production because you will need to make sure it's a bit more secure than this. But the overall concept is that you can communicate with multiple routers, switches, network devices, and you can collect configs, and you can also amend configs, edit configs, and save them. And this is not just Cisco devices, you can do it with Juniper, network devices, any main major vendors you can do it with. And yeah, there we go. So just a quick whistle stop tour of Ansible. Install Ansible, go to etsy hosts, edit the hosts file, and then write your playbook. So you can copy and paste playbooks from multiple website articles. But I just wanted to really just give you a demo of it working and just mention the issue that I had with the Diffie-Hellman. If you want to read more about it, askubuntu.com, and you can see no matching key exchange method. They're offered Diffie-Hellman group 1 SHA-1. There's two fixes really. One is you can actually just add extra options when you SSH from the command line, or so that's option one. That's actually adding the parameters when you just SSH from the command line, or option two, which is I've had it a bit hit and miss so far. But for instance, if you're on a Raspberry Pi, this would also be relevant. So you can go in and you can edit tilde, which is home directory, then .ssh/config, and in there you can add something like this. They said it didn't work. It is hit and miss. I think this article's probably 2 years old. So depends on your distro and depends on numerous things. But there we go. There's another article there. I don't know if it's the same one, is it? No, so that was 5 years ago. So this issue's been around for a while. It's applicable if you're using old hardware. So if you are using old hardware, then you may want to come and read this. This was packetswitch.co.uk. This was the article where I just got the... And again, they're doing it on a Raspberry Pi. It does need to be a Linux device that you actually run Ansible on. Ansible was written by Red Hat. And there we go. Come to ansible.com, run your first playbook. So... yeah, we're really at the very start of this, and as we progress, we'll go through more and more concepts. But they're using something called my_vyos. Ignore that. You want to use the Cisco. If you're on Cisco, just put iOS. Ansible.com documentation. So that's enough from me for now. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, thumbs up, and all that helps the channel. Blah, 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 blah. See you again soon.